Once again, you are welcome to Angel Health Academy. Subject: Community Health Nursing. Topic for the day is Health Economics. Health Economics. The session includes introduction, definition, aim, focus, concepts, need, importance, features, factors influencing health economics, areas of health economics at the family level. Let us discuss in detail about health economics. The term economics is derived from two Greek words, oikos and nomos. Oikos means household and nomos means management. Thus, economics means household management. The father of economics is Adam Smith. The meaning of economics. Economics is the social science that studies the production, distribution, and consumption of goods and services. Then health economics. Health economics is a branch of economics that is concerned with the issues related to the scarcity in the allocation or distribution of health and healthcare services. The scarcity means that available resources are insufficient to satisfy all the wants and needs of the people. So, health economics is a branch of economics which is concerned with issues related to scarcity in the allocation of health and healthcare services. Scarcity simply means that available resources, man, money, material are insufficient to satisfy all the wants and needs of the citizen of the nation or the people. In developing countries like India, where less than 2% of the GDP, gross domestic product, is invested for the delivery of healthcare services or healthcare delivery system, health economics is very essential. So, the developing country like India, we are spending only 2% of the total GDP, gross domestic product, for the healthcare delivery system or for delivering the healthcare services, where health economics is very essential. So, that is the importance of health economics. Next is definition. Health economics is the application of the principles and the tools of economics to healthcare services. In other definition, health economics is a branch of economics concerned with the issues related to the efficiency, effectiveness, value, and behavior in the production and consumption of the health and healthcare services. Next is aim of health economics. The most significant aim of health economics is to provide maximum benefits to the public. That is, reduction in the disease burden of the community and improvement of the people's health and welfare. So, the aim of health economic is to provide maximum benefits to the public, that is, the reduction in the disease burden of the community or the nation and the improvement in people's health and welfare, overall health and welfare. Next is focus of health economics. There are two main focus. First focus is maximum benefit with the least cost. The health economics mainly concentrate on how to extract maximum benefits from the health industry with the least cost or with the cheapest cost. So, the benefits refers to reduction in the disease burden of the community or the people and improvement of the people's health and welfare. The second focus is maximum use of goods and services. That is, maximum use of material things like medicines, surgical instruments, cold chain equipments, lab equipments, drugs, vaccines, diagnostic and therapeutic services, sanitation, environmental sanitation, family planning tools, school health services, occupational services, reproductive and child health services, geriatric services, and even primary health care services. That is, maximum use of the available health care services. Next is concepts of health economics. Health economic concepts includes resources, scarcity, and opportunity. So, let us discuss in detail the resources, scarcity, and opportunity. Resources are inputs, the land, labor, the capital, investment, that all comes under resources, man, money, material. Then scarcity. Scarcity is, one is unlimited nature of human needs and demands. As the population increases, there would be unlimited nature of human needs and demands or wants. But as the population increase, there is a limited available resources. That is comes in scarcity. Then opportunity. Opportunities maximum benefits from the available resources. That is best alternative utilization of the available resources. So the concept of health economics includes resources, scarcity and opportunity. Next is need for health economics. So need for health economics includes medical advances, increased life expectancy, change in family structure and norms, higher expectation from the general people or public, advanced health research and public awareness about their rights of health. So let us explain in detail. First is medical advances. Medical advances, for example, organ transplantation, gene therapy. So new needs are aroused in relation to health services. The new needs are aroused among the people because of the medical advances. Second, increased life expectancy. The more resources are required for medical and continuing care of elderly, the more resources are required as the life expectancy of the person increased from 65 to 72 to 74. So more resources are required for medical and continuation of services or continuing care of the elderly people, because 10% of the total population in India belongs to elderly people. Then third is changes in family structure and norms. At present, elderly may not be cared by their families at home. So the government has another burden to take a special attention and care for the elderly services. That is changing in family structure and norms. That is another need of health economics. The fifth one is advance in health research and concern for the cost effectiveness. Now presently we concern about the cost effectiveness. So advance in health research and concern for the cost effectiveness program in healthcare market. That gives another need for health economics. Then higher expectation from general people. Now people are started to demand for the health and health services. That is higher expectation from the general people about the level of health, and they demand more better healthcare services or comprehensive or quality based accountable health services. The last one is public awareness. So health is the fundamental right of the human being, and it is the responsibility of the government. When the public aware about this, their rights and rights for health and healthcare services, they demand more. These are the important needs of health economics. Next is importance of health economics. What are the importance of health economics? First one is to formulate health policies, then to estimate the real cost of healthcare deliveries, to evaluate the relative cost and benefits, to estimate the effect of economic variables, and to evaluate the planning and budgeting system. Let us discuss in detail. First one is to formulate the health policy and health services. So health economics helps to formulate the health policies and health services. The second is to estimate the real cost of healthcare delivery system. That is to establish the true cost of delivering healthcare and to estimate all the real costs of healthcare delivery system. To evaluate the relative cost and benefits of a particular policy options. So we have so many policies, health related policies. So after the implementation of the policy, we can evaluate the its relative cost and benefits, whether it is really benefited for the public or not. So health economics will help to, or another important of health economics is to evaluate the relative cost benefits of a particular policy options. Fourth one is to estimate the effect of certain economic variables. Economic variables means that expenditure like user charge, time and distance could be taken for services, cost of accessibility of health service to the peripheral level or for the public, etc., on the utilization of health service. So estimate the effect of certain economic variables on the utilization of the healthcare services or health delivery system. Fifth is to evaluate the planning and budgeting system and make possible changes in health planning and health system or healthcare delivery system. The next is features of health economics. What are the features of health economics? Features of health economics include, there are 10 special features of health economics. First is healthcare and medical care is considered as a economic goods in health economics. Second one is health in health economics is considered as a private or public good. Health also considered as a private or public good in health economics. Then measurement of health also considered in economics. Next feature is measurement of health also considered in health economics or economics. Then here health is considered as a stock or it is also an investment. Health is considered as an investment. So in health economics, health is considered as a stock and health is considered as an investment. And in this, loss means in health economics, ill health or disease burden or death rate. And next feature is the planning health and medical care. So health economics includes systematic planning of health and medical care, health care and medical care. Another feature is it includes choice of technology in healthcare delivery systems. That ultimate choice of technology in healthcare delivery system. Ninth feature is provision of equity in relation to healthcare services and outcome from the healthcare services. So provision of equity in healthcare services, that is equal distribution to the all the citizens without any discrimination and equal outcome from all the people from healthcare services. So provision of equity healthcare and healthcare outcomes. Then 10th feature is resource cost and effect on health and medical care. Resource cost and effect on health and medical care. This feature is nothing but cost effectiveness, that is resource cost and effect on health and medical care, that comparisons. So these are the 10 features of health economics. Next is factors influencing health economics. Factors influencing health economics. There are mainly 5 factors can influence the health economics. First one is extensive government interventions. Intractable uncertainty in several dimensions. Several dimensions we may have uncertainty what may happen. Then informative asymmetric. Information is not symmetry with all the people. There is a disparity. Informative asymmetric. Then barriers to entry. Then externalities and presence of third party agency in healthcare delivery system. Externalities and presence of third party agency in healthcare delivery system. Let us explain one by one what are the factors influencing health economics. First one is extensive government intervention. Frequently changing health policy can affect the health economics and healthcare delivery system. That is the first factor, extensive government intervention. Then second one is intractable uncertainty in several dimensions. For example, lack of IPR skill among the health personnel usually decreases the output of healthcare services. This cannot be predictable. This cannot be predictable in advance. So that's called intractable uncertainty in several dimensions. Then next factor is information asymmetry. Seller knows more than the buyer or vice versa. Seller knows more than the buyer. So one party can take advantage on other party because of their lack of knowledge. So the utilization of the health services will be less. Though we render a lot of services, because the public may not be aware about all those services or projects and schemes of the government, that may lead into one party can take advantage on other party's lack of knowledge. That is information asymmetry. Fourth one is barriers to entry. Existence of high startup cost. High startup cost means the cost of starting a healthcare industry is very high. Or there are so many other obstacles that prevent the new competitors in the field of healthcare services. So existence of high startup cost or other obstacle prevent the new competitors in the healthcare services. The last factor is externalities and the presence of third party agent. Externalities and the presence of third party agent. In healthcare, third party is the physician. In healthcare, third party is the physician who makes the purchasing decisions. So physician only decide how many lab tests has to be done, what type of treatment has to be given to the person, that is treatment prescription, etc. So in healthcare, third party is the physician who makes the purchasing decisions. So an economic activity experienced by unrelated third parties may be positive or may be negative. That is labor force of the agency, labor forces of an agency is a positive concept. Pollution emitted by a factory is considered as a negative impact. It affects the health and the environment. Then effect of well-educated services from the part of the health personnel, it is considered as a positive. Positively, it influences the health economics. So externalities and the presence of a third party agent also influence the health economics. So next is about the areas, elements or components of health economics. Areas, elements or components of health economics. There are 8 different areas, elements or components of health economics. First is cost of health care. Second is health problems. Third one is demand for health care. Fourth is supply analysis health care. Fifth one is health care service market. Sixth is financing for healthcare industry. Seventh is health plans and outlays. And last one is eighth is optimum utilization of resources. Let us explain one by one in detail. First is cost of healthcare. The term cost refers to the expenses incurred by the producer to produce the goods and services. So the cost is the expenses incurred by the producer to produce certain goods and services. In health economics, the value of the inputs or resources used for healthcare services is the cost. So in health economics, the cost is the value of the inputs or resources which is used for the healthcare services. The cost for production or healthcare delivery system includes the cost for healthcare services includes wages to the laborers employed, that is salaries or honorarium to the health personnel or health manpower or health staff, price for the raw materials, equipment, furniture, etc., fuel and power used for the rendering the services, the rent for the building if the buildings are rendered, the rate of interest on money borrowed for doing such a business, if there is any loan, etc. So these are the cost of production or cost of healthcare services. Second element is health problems. Every country has its own health problems depending upon various factors such as size of the population, standards of living and geographical condition of the country. So the health problems vary from country to country in relation to the size of the population, standards of living and geographical condition. India is a vast developing country and second highest population, and India is the 7th largest in land area. The major health problems in India are communicable disease problem, non-communicable disease problem, nutritional problems, environmental sanitation problems, medical care problems, population problems and other problems including social problems, etc. The third element is demand for healthcare. Demand for healthcare. Demand is defined as the willingness and ability of a consumer to purchase a given product in a given frame of time. So it is a willingness and ability of a person to purchase a product, a given product in a given frame of time. Concept of demand includes law of demand and demand schedule. Let us explain what is law of demand and demand schedule. So law of demand is a fall in price increases the demand. So when the price of the commodity is decreased, the demand will increase. When the price of the commodity increases, the demand will decrease. So a fall in price increases the demand, increase in price falls in demand. So here you can see that the vertical line indicates the price in rupees and the horizontal line or x-axis indicates the quantity of the demanded product. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. When the price is less, like 2 pounds or 2 rupees, that ordered quantities, demanded quantities are 50. When the price is 10, the ordered quantity is only 10. So this is the law of demand. Second is demand schedule. Demand schedule is a statement which gives information of demand by the consumer at a different level of or different levels of price. Next is factors affecting the demand. There are various factors influence the demand of a product or demand of the services. Change in trend, change in size of the population, climate or weather change, awareness of the consumer or the public, change in income and product improvement. Improvement of the quality of the product. So factors affecting or influencing the demand include change in trend, change in size of the population, change in climate or weather, then awareness of the consumer, increased awareness of the consumer, change in the income of the consumer or the public and improvement of the product. Then healthcare demand. Demand for the healthcare is derived from demand for health. Health viewed as a sort of capital, asset, investment, wealth and the right of the individual. Thus demand has increased. Factors influencing healthcare demand. Factors influencing healthcare demand includes two main factors, patient factor and physician factor. Patient factor and physician factor. Patient factor includes health status of the person. So, health demand is depends upon the health status of person. The demographic characteristics of the persons, that includes gender difference, then age difference, etc. Then economic status of the persons, socio-economic status of the person and others. Second is physician factors. Physician himself or herself is the main factor by prescribing the drugs or treatment for the patients, then admitting the patients into hospitals and ordering the various tests and investigation, etc. So this is the way physician also can influence the healthcare demand. The fourth element is supply analysis in healthcare. Supply of healthcare facilities depends on both internal and external factors. Internal factors includes availability of the funds or budget, government subsidy, grant in aids and encouragement from the state government, and existence of medical and paramedical personnel, drugs, equipment, etc. The external factors includes existence of number of pharmaceutical companies, laboratories and investigating centers and blood banks, etc. Next is difference between demands of healthcare and supply of healthcare. So, demands of healthcare. Demands is the willingness and ability of a consumer to purchase a given product in a given frame of time. Supply is the provision of access or availability of healthcare services. Then, healthcare demand. Demand for healthcare is derived from demand for health. Then, supply of healthcare. Supply of healthcare is the availability of healthcare delivery system from private and government sectors. Then law of demand. Fall in price increase the demand and increase in price fall in demand. In case of supply of healthcare, increase in demand for healthcare decreases in supply. So law of supply is increase in demand for healthcare decreases in supply of healthcare. The factors influencing healthcare demand is patient factor and physician factor. The factors influencing supply of healthcare facilities are internal factors and external factors. There is always constant demand for healthcare services. In case of supply of healthcare, there is always a scarcity or shortage of hospitals, health centers and dispensaries, especially at rural areas. Then, as population increases, health problems also increases. That may lead to increase the demand for healthcare. In relation to supply, the supply of healthcare is in shorter than the demand for healthcare as population increases. That is, supply of healthcare always shorter than the demand for healthcare as the population increases. So these are the difference between demands of healthcare and supply of healthcare. Next is healthcare market. The fifth element is healthcare market. Market is an economic activity of purchase and sale of goods and services at a particular level of price. There are five healthcare markets. First one is healthcare financing market. That is related to the budget for healthcare services. Second one is physicians and nurses services market, that is regarding health personnel. Then third is health institutional services markets, that is related to health centers and health agencies or hospitals. Then fourth one is input factors market, that is the resources. It includes all the resources, man, money, materials. And last one is, fifth one is professional education market for rendering the quality and standard health services to the public. Healthcare market is controlled by the government. The Ministry of Health controls various public and private sector healthcare markets. The private sector also controlled through the legislation passed by the Parliament of India. Consumers of healthcare markets often suffer from lack of adequate information about what services they need to buy and which providers offer the best. Because we have allopathy, we have indigenous system of medicines, we have both private and government agencies, still the consumer of healthcare market often suffer from lack of adequate information about the services and about the best providers of the services. Then demand and supply of healthcare market. Demand and supply of healthcare market. There will be constant demand for healthcare services as population increases. As population increases, health problems also increases, which lead to increase the demand of healthcare services. Then supply side of the healthcare market. Always there is a scarcity or shortage of hospitals, health centers, dispensaries, especially in the rural areas, where 25% of services are only available for the 74% of the total population in the rural area. Then as private sectors concentrate on profit, poor patients cannot avail the facilities from private hospitals, private nursing homes and clinics, etc. As it is costly for them. Thus, the supply of healthcare is in short than the demand for healthcare. Hence, it is the responsibility of the government to provide primary healthcare to all the villages throughout the country. So, it is the ultimate responsibility of the government to provide primary healthcare to all the villages throughout the country. This is the another importance of application of economics in healthcare sector, that is health economics. Then income and budget. Income is the outcome of productive activity. Income is the outcome of a productive activity. There are two types of income, personal income and national income. Personal income is nothing but it is the income of an individual. It is an income of an individual. National income is the an aggregate, that is gross total income of all the people in the country. So the total annual value of all goods and services produced in the country, measured in forms of money, also called as national income. The national income data provides a summary statement of a country's aggregate economic activities. So national income provides a summary statement of a country's aggregate economic activity. National income measured by statistics such as net national income, NNI, which measures the total income of individuals, corporations and government in the economy. Which measures the total income of individuals, corporations and government in the economy. So national income may equal to national products and national income may even equal to national expenditure. The model of circular flow of economic activities. So this is the model of circular flow of economic activities. From the households, people use the income to the firm or industry. Industry considered as a firm is considered as the producing unit where the goods and products are produced. Again, these goods and products are used by the households as a consuming unit. So household is the consuming unit and firm is the producing unit. So household consume the goods and product which is produced by the firm. So it is a circular flow. Economic activities actually is a circular form, starting from household, then household people use the income in the firm and firm will produce the goods and products and that will be utilized by the household. Like that it will be, the cycle will be continued. And budget. Budget refers a list of planned expenses and revenues. Revenues are incomes. Purchasing power. It is the volume of a thing or good compared to the amount paid with money in currency. So it is the volume of a thing or good compared to the amount paid with money, that is currency. Then income and purchasing power. The purchasing power of an individual or family decreases when the price of the commodities increases, but the income remains same. So the purchasing power of any individual or the family decreases when the price of the commodities or the materials increases, but the income remains same. Thus, the purchasing ability is affected by the increase or decrease of the income of an individual. The purchasing ability is affected by the increase or decrease income of an individual. Then, effect of income on purchasing power. So, when the income is increased and price of the commodity remain in the same, the purchasing power is always will be increased. Then when the income is increased, price of commodity also increased. So there is increased price, no effect of purchasing power, or purchasing power will be the same. When the income is decreased, the price of commodity either remains same or it is increased, automatically the purchasing power will be decreased. So this is the effect of income on purchasing power. Then sixth element is the financing for healthcare industry. Financing for healthcare industry. The source of health finances for the healthcare delivery from commercial banks, public sector banks, private foreign banks and cooperative sector banks. The source of health finance usually from commercial banks, public sector banks, private foreign banks and from cooperative sector banks. Next is health plans and outlays. The seventh element is health plans and outlays. Economic planning. Economic planning is a well thought process initiated by the central government to fulfill the certain objectives and targets through optimum utilization of the natural and human resources within the specified period. Health plans in India. A conscious and well designated schemes and programs for better health for the entire population is called health plans. Health planning is an integral part of the national socio-economic planning. So it is an integral part of the national socio-economic planning. The guidelines for organizing national health planning and health services were provided by number of health planning committees in India. Then 5-year plans. There are 12 5-year plans in India. 5-year plan started in 1951 with the objective of to rebuild the rural India, and later it was ended in 2017 with the 12th 5-year plan. So there are 12 5-year plans in India. 5-year plan started in 1951 with the objective of to rebuild the rural India, and later in 2017 it was ended with the last 12th 5-year plan. The 8th element is optimum utilization of the available resources. So available resources for healthcare delivery system or self delivery services are 3 MM: man, money and material. Man, health professionals, and capital, money and other resources, that is materials. The last session is health economics at family level. Health economics at the family level. Health economics at the family level is to help its members to spend their money effectively for safeguarding their health and welfare. It can be done through family budgeting. Health economics at the family level is to help its members to spend their money effectively for safeguarding their health and welfare. It can be done through family budgeting. In this video, I am not discussing about family budgeting. Family budgeting I'll make or upload a separate video later. Then in this video, I would like to talk about the health economics at the family level. There are some ways or tips for the family to practice health economics. First one is, the family take advantages of the, or family can take the advantages of routine immunization schedule and basic health services or primary health services from sub-center, primary health center, community health center, government hospitals, and even from medical colleges. Then family can also follow the healthy lifestyles by avoid smoking, drinking, other substance abuse consumption, then avoiding excess salt, sugary preparation and junk foods, then doing regular physical activities by all the family members, and doing meditation and yoga, etc. The third way is family can even obtain the health insurance for themselves. And when the family feel or any family member feel ill, they at once seek medical care from a qualified medical practitioner. That is early detection from a qualified medical practitioner. So these are the some of the ways to practice the health economics by the family members. So in short, at present, the art of household management is applied by every person, that is both by the government and individual, to get the maximum satisfaction. Both are trying to solve many economic problems in day-to-day life with the help of the health economics. Thus, health economics play a key role, an important role in healthcare delivery system to promote the health and welfare of the people in the country. So far we have discussed about the introduction, definition, aim, focus, concepts, need, importance, features, factors influencing health economics, areas of health economics, and last, health economics at the family level. So thanks for watching. Hope this video really benefits in your studies. If you feel it is worth and benefit, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Stay tuned with Angel Health Academy till we meet with another and important educational video. Thank you.